delicate and small and thin, but he looked no different than he had, you know, for years to me.
Did you meet him through your father?
Originally, yeah. I've known him now for about 20 years.
And how old are you?
I'm 34.
So you were a kid when you met him?
I was.
Did you stay here as a kid?
Yeah, the guest house, which is right over there, that was, you know, where I stayed the first time I came here with my father. We ate in the main house over there, which is the first time I met Michael. And I grew up with Michael Jackson as an idol. I had the silver glove. I bought a red leather jacket and cut it up so it looked like it was from Thriller, much to my parents' horror. But, you know, when I met him, it was just like a dream come true.
This is like... Then this had to be an adventure for you. You were 14. What was it like?
It was like walking into a fairy tale. I mean, you know, the music, just the elegance, the fun, the carnival rides. So that first time it was a quick visit just with my father. I subsequently came here through the years, brought my cousins, brought my friends, and Michael just loved having, you know, people. He loved playing. So it was great here.
Did you ever buy any of the stories, the molestation stories, all that?
You know,
how'd you feel?
I felt conflicted. I mean, obviously, but I could only speak to my experience. Like I said, coming here as a 14-year-old for the first time, spending all this time with Michael and never feeling uncomfortable in his presence. I mean,
first time you met him, what was your impression?
Yeah, I was in awe, obviously. I mean, I was sort of speechless, but he immediately put me at ease. You know, the first Batman movie had just come out, or it was just coming out, and he asked me, do you want to, like, see if he had a movie theater here. He said, do you want to go to a private screening, just you, me, and my dad? And I said, yeah, absolutely. So we went and watched, and, you know, I saw it, like, a month before it came out. It was amazing, and he immediately put me at ease. I mean, I felt comfortable. I mean, he felt, in some ways, while he was probably 30 years old at the time, I mean, he felt like a kid himself.
So you don't feel sadness here?
I do. I mean, I think there's a bit
of
sadness.
You feel both, though?
Yeah. I feel both. I mean, I think it's great we're celebrating him, and everybody who's here is you know, feels him here, which is great. It's great to see his family, Jermaine, here. So
we've been at the Neverland Ranch. We've been here all day, and we've had quite a night, and we'd love to come back again. From the Neverland Ranch, this has been Larry King Live.